described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Women Make Movies, Inc. presents Apache 8.
Firefighters say they are gaining ground on the giant Sholo fire in Arizona, thanks in part to a remarkable team of firefighters.
NBC News, June 26, 2002.
A call in the middle of the night is routine for 51-year-old Cheryl Bone.
She sips up a pack.
Since 1976, Bones has been crew boss for Apache No. 8, and that means travel, often for weeks at a time. 21 days without a break, 90 hours a week on the line. They have a reputation for killing the toughest of fire. By reservation standards, where jobs are scarce, the pay is good.
Cheryl.
We went out that we left our families behind. I had three kids that I left behind, 5, 2, and 1 years old when I started. That was pretty tough.
Chip Reed, NBC News, Sholo, Arizona.
While one woman checks the pack she's wearing, Cheryl moves equipment. Another woman watches a fire.
You never knew what you were going to face. You were with a bunch of women that could handle anything.
Small fires burn around them.
My people respect me because I'm putting my life on the line to protect what is ours, the beauty of the reservation.
A flat meadow is dotted with green bushes, with a mountain sloping in the background. A shadow covers small buildings and roads with sun beyond them.
When they first started, they were probably the only all-women's crew, firefighting crew that was out there. This all-male firefighting camp would be becoming organized, the camp setting up. Then all of a sudden, there's these ladies that come into camp and everybody's wondering exactly what's going on here. All heads would turn.
A photo shows them arriving. Crew member Steffi Kinney.
We ran into a couple of crews from Montana, and they go, man, we hear a lot of stuff about how just nothing but ladies can outwork some of these men. And we're like, yeah, pretty much can.
Robert LaCappa.
Their original title was Apache 6.
BIA Fort Apache Agency.
475. They were looking for dependable individuals, and they found out that the women were very dependable over the men crews that they had. The gentleman who thought about pulling together a woman's firefighting crew, he went ahead and took that thought over to the tribal council.
Marjorie Grimes.
It was an uphill battle.
Apache 6 crew leader.
Not open to women firefighters. We had to fight for the right to fight fires, I mean, as women. Since I was, like, outspoken and really aggressive, they made me the Apache 6 crew leader.
She laughs in an old photo and poses with her crew in another.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.